All right, so let's say we have this account object, right?
Okay.
And the scenario is, so listen it carefully. So if there are multiple users in this org, then only the users who will be creating the accounts, he will be able to access the accounts. No other else should be able to access the accounts. Okay.
Okay.
So it's the concept of record level security. So because we are trying to control the record level access of account records, right?
Yes. So the owner of the record will only be able to see the records, right? Okay.
Right. So if that's the case, what you have to do is you have to go to the sharing settings.
I'm not able to see your screen properly. It's just showing me half of your screen.
Half of screen?
Yeah. Yes. I see multiple screens now.
Wait a minute.
I don't know what is happening.
Let me share it again. Can you see it?
Not yet.
Let me know once you can see.
Yes, I can see now. Yeah.
Okay, so to deal the record level access of any object, you have to go to the sharing settings. Okay.
Okay.
So this is sharing settings. So sharing settings will define how the records will be accessible to the users.
Okay.
So now we are dealing with the account records, right? So we go to accounts here and we will check what is the internal access, because users is nothing but the internal users of this Salesforce.
Yeah.
So to talk about the internal access. So here, if you can see, the internal access is defined to public read write.
Okay.
Public read write means this is accessible to everyone. This is accessible to public. Means anyone will be able to see the accounts.
Okay.
Or the accounts. And we have to limit it to what? To private, right?
Yeah.
So we will make it private from here. Okay. So now the account sharing is private. That means only the owner of the accounts will be able to access the accounts.
Okay. Okay. And this we are changing at the object level, right?
This is not object level. This is sharing settings.
Sharing settings. Okay.
Yes, sharing settings on the object.
So this is, so I'm just trying to understand. This is the impact on the role, like this is at the profile level that we're making the change, or I'm a little confused.
So, if you see, there is a checkbox which is saying grant using hierarchies.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what do you mean by hierarchy? In Salesforce, there is only one hierarchy, that is role hierarchy.
Yes.
So we are giving the access as private by saying that we are granting the access by using role hierarchies, means it's the role level access.
Okay. So my question is, now that you've made account as private, so in a profile, now this is set up at the, okay, this is set up at org-wide defaults, like this is private now at org-wide. So whenever I'm creating a profile, say XYZ profile, and I give access to accounts, automatically accounts will have that private read and write permission. So it will not like only the record owner will be able to create those records and able to see his or her record, and the person on the top of the hierarchy,
right? So the profile level means whether the account will be accessible or not.
Okay.
If yes, then how it will be accessible, that will be defined in the sharing settings.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Okay.
So now we will just save it. So now the accounts is private. So once the account is private, only the owners will be able to see it. Now let's say
it's still it's public read write.
Yeah, it will take time.
Okay. Okay, no, it takes time. Yeah, it takes time to refresh.
Yeah, so now our scenario will be now, okay, we have made the accounts to private. That means only the record owners will be able to access it.
Okay.
So now we want to make sure that another user, only another user, not everyone, only another user should be able to access this account. Apart from the owner, we want another user to access this account.
Okay.
Now this is the scenario.
So will the other user be on one level above in hierarchy? Like, will be the leader or boss for this person? Okay.
How the hierarchy works is, if the lower level person has the access, then automatically the upper level people will have the access.
Oh, okay. Okay. Because we've checked grant using hierarchy, so automatically the team leader for that person will be able to see his records.
Right. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
And as the account is standard object, okay, so that's why this checkbox will always be set to true. You cannot change it.
Can you repeat that again?
For standard object, you have to provide the access using hierarchy.
Okay, okay.
For custom object, you can uncheck it as well. Means you don't want to give the access using role hierarchy.
Okay, okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So now if you want to, let's say same level user, both the users are on same level. So we are trying to extend the access of the account to another user.
Okay. So it's just one scenario, or every time the other user should be able to see the person's record?
No, let's say you are the user. Okay. And you have created one account record. So now you only can say it. Now let's say another colleague of yours is needed to see that account.
Okay.
So you have to share that account with the other person so that they can see it, right?
Okay. Okay.
So you are trying to extend the account access to for another user.
But we have to first see, no? The other user profile should have access to the account object or not. Like at the profile level, do they have access to the account?
That's already in place. Okay.
Okay. Okay. So then,
users can read the account. Means he already have the access through profiles or permission sets.
Okay. Okay.
Already assumed. Okay.
Okay. So manual sharing.
Right. So there are few sharings we have in Salesforce.
Okay.
So we can see that now. So this is sharing rule, and this sharing rule we use to extend the access of a record. Okay. So now if you create new, there will be few type of the sharing rules you can see. Based on record owner and based on criteria. So based on record owner means, if you go to the step 3, what is it saying? Just read it out.
Select which records to be shared.
Yeah. So which records to be shared to whom? Okay.
Okay.
So here our thing is, the records owned by you should be shared with that another user.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
So here, accounts owned by you. So you cannot select an user from here. So it will be on the role level.
Okay.
That means accounts owned by your role will be shared with that role the user reports to.
Okay. Okay. So that means, if some other person has same role as mine, his records will also be shared with the other person.
Right.
Okay.
So it's the role level sharing.
Okay. We cannot do it user wise.
I will tell you how to do that in user wise. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
This is role level. For example, whatever CFO is having, so whatever users are there under CFO and whatever accounts they have in their line, that will be shared with the role, let's say COO.
Okay.
And here you can also provide the access level. So here it can be read only or read write as per the requirement.
Okay.
Maybe you can name it like this. Okay, save it. Okay, so now we have created a sharing rule which will share the records with another users based on the roles.
Okay.
All right, so now manual sharing, how to share a record with only one user?
Can we do one for before that, criteria based sharing rule?
Yeah, I will show you.
Okay.
So let's go to the account. Let's say you want to share this account, only this account, with the another user only.
Okay.
So here you will see one sharing button.
Okay.
You have to click on that. And here you can see there are four options you have. You can either select user, public group, role, or roles and subroles.
Okay.
Here you can see, search the user, provide the user here, search it, and provide the level of access you want to give, and then save. Okay.
And what is this opportunity access?
Yeah, it's account. See, opportunity and case is related to account, right?
Okay.
So whatever you will give, I mean, always.
Okay, so that means if case and opportunity access is private, then they won't have access to the case and opportunity record, only the account record.
Right. Okay. Here you can also give the access to case if it is needed.
Okay. Got it.
Yeah. So this is manual sharing.
Okay. And
previous was role-based sharing. Okay. So now I will show you the criteria based. So let's take one example. Let's say whenever the account's country is India, so there is one role. Just assume there is one role called Indian managers. Okay.
Okay.
Now, if the account's country is India,
okay,
we can share all such accounts with the Indian managers.
Okay.
Okay. So here we have to create a criteria of a sharing rule saying that, okay, the account's country is India.
Mm-hmm.
So whenever that criteria is satisfied, we will be sharing that account with the India manager's role.
Okay.
Like, okay. So to do that, you have to create a new. You have to select this one.
Based on criteria, okay.
Here, country will be one field. Let's say billing country. Let's say equals India, for example. So now we have to share it with the Indian manager role. So now I do not have that. So I am sharing with channel sales team. So whenever the account's country is India, we are sharing that account with this with this role. Okay.
Not, yeah.
And you can here, you can make it either read-only or read-write.
Okay.
So this is, you can say, basic understandings on the sharing settings. So role-based sharing rule, then criteria-based sharing rule, then you can do manual sharing. And this is one way of sharing, like role-level hierarchy and the OWL.
Okay.
And also, there is one more thing. For example, let's say there are, let's say, okay, let me go to the role here, okay? So let's say these are all the roles, level of roles.
Okay.
So we have, I mean, account sharing is private, means it is already private. Now we want to share an account with the VP marketing, only one user of VP marketing and one specific user of this customer support.
Okay.
There are two users, one from VP marketing and one from customer support North America.
Okay.
So we have to
we don't want to share with the role, like full all the users under that role, or we're sharing with
only one user. Yeah, there are two users, one from VP marketing and one from North America.
Okay.
And you have to share that account only those two users, but without manual sharing.
Okay.
Because if there are 100 users, then you cannot create 100 manual sharings, right?
Yes.
So to do that, you have to create one public role. Okay.
Okay.
And we have to create one public group, and then we have to add those users in that public group first.
Okay.
Here, let's say public group name is and you have to add the users.
Okay.
So let's say these are the two users we have to add.
Okay.
And then let's say whenever the account's country is USA,
mm-hmm.
have to share that account with this public group. Okay.
Okay.
So for that, you can create one more sharing rule.
And if there is no condition, just like there was, you have to share all the records with those two people in the public group. So then what do you put the condition as?
So here you have to find out the required field. Okay. Means if you create an account, that field has to be populated with some value. Okay. For example, there is account name or account number, right? Because whenever you create an account, it has to have a name. Without a name, an account cannot be
created. Oh, yes. Okay.
So you have to say that that name is not equals blank. If you don't put it, it is blank. So if the name is not equals blank, that means there is a valid account which can be shared.
Got it. Yeah.
So here, yeah, so let's say public group. So here you can see when the account name not equals blank, then you just need to select the public group that you've created. Okay.
Oh, okay.
And you can provide the access level here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So this is useful when the users will be from different roles, not from the same roles, right? If the users are in different roles, then the public groups will be useful.
And we're not assigning, like we're not sharing with all the users in that one role. We're very selective users.
Right.
Okay, got it. Can you also add one new role in middle of the hierarchy that you were using earlier? Like,
yeah, you can.
Like somewhere in the middle.
You can add here. Okay.
Okay.
Junior or section. CEO, then CEO, then junior CEO. Okay.
Now, how will you, so we, after adding this role, don't you need to give any other, like maybe, we don't need to do anything, just we have created a role now, and whenever we're creating a new user, we just assign this role.
Yeah.
Okay. It will automatically take the account OWD as private, then the sharing rules will apply automatically if there is any role-based sharing rule.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Accounts will be shared. Yeah.
Okay.
So one more thing, important one. I don't think this will be available in this orgs. Okay, so there is one more thing. In DevOps, it is not available. So in real time, what happens is there can be, let's say, 10 lakhs or 20 lakhs accounts, right?
Okay.
So now, let's say your system already has 10 or 20 lakhs accounts. Now, if you want to add one more role, right? So all the accounts will be reshared with that role, right?
Sorry, can you say the line last line again?
Let's say there are 10 to 20 lakhs accounts, right?
Yeah.
So after all the data is present, now if you want to create a new role, okay?
Okay.
Then all the accounts will be shared with the role according to the role hierarchy.
Yeah, yeah.
So that means in the back end, Salesforce has to process 10 to 20 lakhs accounts only for addition of one role.
One new role, yeah, got it.
Right. So in real time, it will take a hell lot of time.
Yeah.
So we don't do that. So there is a option called deferred sharing, means if the sharings can be stopped for some time, and then after that it can resume.
Okay. So we cannot see it here how we do it.
Yeah, because in dev I don't think they provide this.
Okay, so let me just understand it one more time. So we have already set up the whole role hierarchy the way we have it here. Now if you want to add another role and there's a lot of data in the background, so we have to go to default sharing and stop the sharing.
Yeah, right.
So what impact will it have on the users who are live in the system, like who are working?
No, so what you can do is whenever the users will not be working, means outside the working hours of the users, if there is no real-time data processing, right?
Oh, okay.
That time you have to process the sharing.
And then once it stops, let's say users are not working at that time and it stops, after I add a role, then I have to resume it to again start sharing.
Yeah, because if you do not resume and complete it, users won't be able to have the access to the records, right?
Okay. So, but then won't it process it again and again? So it will take time, right? Again, if it's...
Of course, yeah. That's why you have to process in the outside the working hours.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. So this is basically sharing settings. And one more thing, if you are curious, you should be knowing this.
Mm-hmm.
For every object, we have a thing called, this is a inspector, okay? And here you can join the SQL queries. And why I am showing you this, for every object, there is another object called account share, if you see. It's an automatically it would be available for all the objects.
Okay.
So this object is actually used to process the shares, how the records will be shared.
Okay. Can you show me? I'm confused.
Yeah.
And also I want to learn about the Salesforce inspector also. We can talk about it later, but.
So here, if you see how the accounts are shared with whom, everything is mentioned here.
So account share ID. So ID is the account ID.
Yeah.
And account.
No, this ID, forget about this one. We will talk about later.
Okay.
So these are all the account shares. For example, this account is shared with one user whose name is me, in Shoham Ghosh, and the account access level is all. That means I have created this, or I am the administrator.
Okay. And and let's see the edit access. So what does that mean then?
See, we have given the edit access to that public group, right?
Yeah.
You can see that this public group user should also be able to access, means edit the accounts, because we have given the retried access.
Okay, but what is the important? So I didn't understand what is the use of account share or any other share object that we have.
Yeah. So let's say, forget about the criteria of sharing. Okay. So let's say you want to share some account records with some user or group of users using Flow. Okay.
Okay.
So how you'll be sharing the accounts using Flow? So in the Flow, you have to create a record for account share object. You have to mention the account's ID you want to share with, okay. And you have to put the user's ID that for which you for whom you have to share it with.
Okay.
So in Flow also we can create the sharings for any object. Okay. That's the way of sharing.
Okay. Flows, I want to do it properly. Like maybe we can start.
But before that, you have to know this also.
Okay. So it's just that so account sharing is only used when we are sharing a record. Account share or case share, anything that we have, it's only when we're sharing the record with other user.
Right. So it always, these case shares, account share will always hold the share of the records, how they are shared, which records are shared, and which records are shared to whom.
So is it also possible that let's say there are two users, A and B, no, three users, A, B, and C, and there's one account, say test one. Now, test one is shared between A and B. It is owned by A. A created test one, and it is shared with B. Now, this test one is also shared with C using manual sharing. So, account share will have two records of test one saying that it's shared with B and shared with C.
Yeah, two records will be there. One with A and one with C.
Okay. Got it.
So, it's kind of a register. So, later in your, whenever you're working in a project, you might have to run this query to see which records are shared with them like that.
Okay. So what is the basic in what scenarios do we use Salesforce Inspector?
In all the scenarios, for example, data load you can use, or let's say you want to see what accounts are there and you want to download it. So how
that
to do
we
that?
Do it through data loader also, no? We can export it.
Yeah, but it's a long process. You have to install data loader and download it.
So if you want to do mass update, then also you can use this inspector, Salesforce Inspector.
Yeah.
Okay.
Possible with this. So here you can see these are all the account records present in this org.
Okay.
So you cannot download it, but what you can do is you can just copy this Excel format and you can paste it in the Excel, MS Excel.
Okay, it doesn't give you that Excel copy, like the way data loader gives.
This is Excel copy.
Excel. Data loader gives that success and error files, na, .csv.
And that will, whenever you load some data, that you are extracting that data here.
Yeah, even for extraction, data loader will give you the extract of the CSV, na? I'm just asking if I use just Salesforce.
Yeah, right. CSV, right? This is a CSV. You can copy this and you can paste in the CSV.
That's okay, right. I have to paste it in the CSV. Okay, so if I just use Salesforce Inspector, I can do away with data loader. I don't need to use data loader then.
Right, you don't need to use.
Okay. So this is more powerful than data loader or data loader?
Say, but for large set of data means there is option in data loader that you can use bulk API.
Batch API, yeah.
So that is not really possible right now here. But later they provide that approach, but right now it's not available.
Okay. What else all we can do with Salesforce Inspector, like upload, extract, update, upsort?
All the CRUD operations you can do using Inspector.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And also if you could share some these SQL queries that we use in Salesforce Inspector with me so that I can practice.
Yeah, we will do that. But first, let's revise the thing.
Yes. Yeah, let's come back. Yeah.
So this is about the record level sharing. I believe that's clear to you.
Okay.
And, So now we can start with the object level access.
Yeah.
So let's say, as you said, that we have the accounts country field, right?
Okay.
So now we want to make sure that country field is accessible to few profiles only. Not all the profiles, but that country field will be accessible to only few profiles and it won't be accessible for other few profiles.
Okay.
So this is actually, we are controlling the level of field level access, right? We are controlling the field level access of an object.
Okay. So that means only the country field will not be available to those profiles, but the account as a like object, the records in the account will be visible.
Yeah, that is a different scenario.
Okay.
We are only talking about the field here.
Okay.
So here, to control the field level security, first you go to any field. For example, we are talking about country here. So you can, okay. It's basically, let's talk about only the source, account source, forget about the country. So we are providing the field level security for account source field to few profiles.
Why doesn't it have a country?
Because it comes under address. You can composite field is there.
I think it should be billing, yeah.
So both this billing address and shipping address will have all the details, country, city, everything.
Okay,
so let's say this field. So we want to control the field level security. So here you can see this button. So here currently you can see this is available to most of the profiles, but we don't want that. We want only few profiles to be shared with, let's say system admin, and let's say standard user, and let's say this standard platform user.
Okay.
So only these three profiles, this account source field will be visible.
Okay.
So also we have one more thing here. So we want standard user and system admin to edit this field, but the standard platform user to only see the field. They cannot edit. They can only see this.
Okay.
So to make sure that, we can just check this read-only checkbox.
Okay. So if we check visible, then they can edit also.
Right.
If we check only read-only, then it's just read-only.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So this is how the field level securities are provided.
Okay.
Okay. So now if you want to talk about the object level security, let's say for account, now we are determining what type of access you should give the account for the profiles.
Yes.
So for that, you have to go to profiles here. So we have many profiles. So let's say the standard user profile can only have the read access for the accounts.
For the object, they'll have this
object level.
Okay.
Yeah. Read access on the object level. The standard user profile should have the read access on the object level for account.
But if they, so that means they're not able to create their own records also.
Right.
So referring back to the previous example where we did on the sharing set is org-wide, that account should have private. So except the standard user profile, other profiles will have the access to create the account, but only they'll be able to see their own records.
Correct.
Okay.
Okay. So there are a few level of access that you will see. So let's edit this. And you have to find the object level settings. So here, the standard object permission is here.
Okay. Okay.
So if you can see here, you cannot edit this. Read, create, edit, and delete. All the access are given for this profile. And you cannot edit this. Why? Because it's a standard profile. This is a standard user. You cannot edit it. Salesforce doesn't allow that.
Okay. So I have to create a custom profile?
Yeah, you can create one custom profile. You can clone it from here. Or I can go to some profile which is already there. Let's say this one.
Okay.
So here you have to find the object level access. So here you can remove these accesses. So there are these type of access: read, create, edit, and delete. Then view all and modify all. So if you select view all and modify all, you can see what is this? The data administration. This is related to data administration as well. Means the record level as administration. Means if you select view all or modify all, anything, then no sharing settings will be applied here. These profile users will be able to see all the records of the accounts.
Oh, okay.
Even if it is made private.
I'm a little confused. Yeah. So right now it is checked on the read. Plus if we click on view all, so that means this profile will be able to view.
These profile users will be able to see all the account records.
Okay, but not edited.
But not edited.
Okay.
The account is private in OWD, right?
Yeah, but still they'll be able to see every record.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. If you select modify all, that means they would be able to see and edit all the records.
Okay. Okay.
So if this scenario comes in your org, so you have to verify that profile level access, that view all should not be here. If view all is given, that profile user should be able to edit any account records.
Okay. Okay.
So now we are just making the account to read access. Okay.
Okay.
So whatever users are there on this profile, custom sales profile, he would be able to only see the account that has been shared with them.
Okay. That has to be shared. Otherwise, they won't be able to, so they cannot create their own records, and they have to see the records of other users only if it has been shared with them.
Right, because the create access is not also given.
And what if they're one step like on the role hierarchy? So one is a team leader who has this custom sales profile, and they have a customer care professional underneath them. So then the customer care professional can create the accounts and see his or her own records. But this team leader at the sales profile cannot create accounts, but can see.
The lower level records. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is the profile level, and also, so let's say in one profile, let's say this is the profile, custom sales profile. Okay. Yeah. And now we have given the account to read access only. So now let's say in this profile, there are 10 users.
Okay.
So by default, if you are you have made the account level access to read in the profile level, that means all the users of this profile will be only able to see the accounts, right?
Yes.
So now we want only one user from that 10 users of this profile who should be able to edit the account as well.
Permission set.
Yeah.
Okay.
So to do that, you have to just go to permission set here.
So we're not creating a new profile. We're just giving them one step more permission.
Right. Extra permission you will give. Let's say account. Okay, so here you'll go to object settings. This is accounts. You can edit here. Okay, you just need to give the create access. The read access already there in the profile level. Okay. And we're giving the create access and save it. And then you can assign this permission set to any user that you need. Okay.
I can assign it to a group also, public group.
Yeah, you can assign to a group as well.
Okay. Okay. No, okay. There are no groups.
So here you will see only the users. But if you go to the group, there would be an option to assign the permission sets as a group.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. So this is more about the object level and field level access. So now let's say there are 10 permission sets, okay, that we are giving the 10 permission, we are assigning 10 permission sets to one user.
Okay.
Okay. And in future, more permission sets can be added. So instead of giving 10 permission sets one at a time to that user, it's better. It's better to use this permission set group.
Okay.
So in this permission set group, you can create a group of permission set, and there you can provide those 10 or 11 permission sets in there. And then you can assign this permission set group to that user.
Okay. So that means if those are 10 permission set, I'll create a new permission set group, add those sets, and then just I'll assign the group, and automatically those permission sets will be assigned.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So these are mostly the security of records and metadata. So now you tell me if you have any questions.
No, I think so. On the sharing settings admin part, is this all, or is there something other, like other topics also?
Yeah, this is mostly the security one.
Okay. No, I think I don't have any questions.
Okay, so tomorrow we can see the page layouts, record, lightning record pages, those things, record types, those things we can see on the tomorrow session.
We can do it now also if you want. Like,
if you start new thing now, it will take time.
So will you be able to complete it like tomorrow?
Yeah. So those things will be completed tomorrow.
Okay. And can you do you use other workbench also as a tool?
Yeah, I used, but right now it's not needed, because if you have inspector, then you don't need workbench or data loader.
What is the difference between workbench and inspector?
See, workbench is a third party tooling API. Okay, so this is extension, browser extension, you can say. This is just a browser extension you need to install.
Yeah. Okay.
And it would be, I mean, getting all the data from Salesforce inside here itself.
Yeah. Okay.
Log into Workbench icon.
No, so I'm just trying to understand, what is the difference? Like, is it different from data loader and inspector, or no? It's the same tool.
See, you can see, of course, this is a different tool, but you can do all the works that you can do with data loader and Workbench.
Okay. And if I want to make an update here, how will I make an update here in the Salesforce Inspector? Like, if I want to update country on an account, mass update.
There is data import, right? And here you just need to provide the file. You just need to paste the file here.
No, but if I don't, so I'm using Salesforce Inspector. First, I have to get all the accounts, IDs, and then paste the IDs here, and then update the country. I'm trying to do an update on the existing account records that change the country to, say, India.
Yeah, so that is a data load, right? Data load with update. You are updating multiple records, right?
Yeah, that is what I'm asking. So if I'm just using Salesforce Inspector and not data loader, can I do it through Salesforce Inspector?
Yeah, I'm telling you how to do that. There is no country. So billing address, billing country, let's say. So what you can do is, you have to copy this Excel format, okay?
Yeah.
So now, let's say, just give it. So let's say these are the four accounts. You want to make it India, right?
Okay.
Copy this Excel format.
Okay.
Go to change the billing country, then again come back to data import.
Sorry, your voice broke there. Copy this data, then
copy Excel format or CSV, go to Excel, okay, paste it,
yeah,
then change the country,
yeah,
again copy that Excel, okay,
okay,
and then paste it here. You can update.
Oh, okay.
Understood, right?
Yeah. And then we have to do the same field mapping as we do it in data loader also.
Yeah. You can select the fields you want here.
Okay. And can you also show me in that Salesforce org, where do I see the API names? Like, is there any extension? I know in the field and on the object, I can go to fields and see their API names. But I want to see if I want to like quickly check what's the API name for that particular field.
So you can just query this from like this. So this is account. You want to check all the field API names, right? So wait a minute. You are using Mac or Windows?
Right now I'm using Mac, but I'll be using Windows only.
So in Windows, it is just the problem. Yeah. So in Windows, you can just hold Control and Shift here. Okay.
Control and Shift. Okay.
Yeah. Then all the fields will be selected here.
No, can you go back to that record Burlington textiles on the top, the third tab that I see?
Where is that?
The Salesforce dev org that you have opened. On the top in the tab, I see Burlington Textiles record, account record.
Here also you can check one thing. Let me show you. Man, that's the problem. Just a minute. Reload it. You can click on show all data.
I cannot see anything on the screen if you're making anything on the screen.
Can you see?
I can see just the Salesforce inspector page.
Well, let me reshare it. You can see, right?
Not yet.
Yeah, let me know once you can see.
Yeah, I can.
Yeah, so here in the inspector, you can see there's an option of show all data.
Okay.
Click on that. So here you'd be able to see all the field API names.
Okay. How did you come on this page? So can you go back to that record page again? What did you click on? The sales. Okay, this is an extension here. Okay, got it.
Yeah, show all data, then it will give you the field API names along with the value.
And it will give me for that particular object where on which record I am. So for that particular object, it is showing me. It will. So for the admin, it will show me all the hidden fields also.
Yeah, all the fields you can see.
Okay. And is there a query that I can just use in Salesforce Inspector to update for a particular record? So let's say there's a textile account, whatever the account ID is.
Yeah, only one. I mean, directly you cannot do it. But here, if you see, this is one only record, right?
Yeah.
You can edit here and you can provide the values and you can save.
Oh, okay. But if I want to do it using Salesforce Inspector, like I give the ID, say I select ID equals to.
Directly, we don't allow you. We have to do again copy Excel and paste.
Copy Excel, okay. So I have to extract first that whole account record, then copy it in CSV, and then paste it again, and then do the update. Okay. And what else? Anything else that we can do from Salesforce Inspector? No.
Yeah, you can navigate to page layout. You can view the record in Salesforce object setup. Both you can do. Also, you can clone any record. All the actions that are allowed to you, you can do that. Clone, you can do. Delete, you can do. Export also, you can do. Okay.
And if I delete a record, it will go to that recycle bin, like where it stays for 10 days, I think. What, how, where do I see that?
So here only, if you go to the setup, I think you have to go to classic. Okay, you have to go to recycle bin.
Yeah,
and you can see any record here which were deleted, and then you can undelete it as well.
But I have to go to classic for this.
I think in Lightning also, let me show you. Here in the app launcher, you have to search recycle.
Oh, okay, yes. Okay, it's in the app launcher.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. And okay. Covering on the tomorrow's class?
Same time is fine, right?
Same time is fine. And what all topics are we covering in the tomorrow's class?
Mostly on the page layout, record types, and Lightning record pages.
Okay, I want to do more on Lightning record pages, like the dynamic actions and everything. Okay, yeah. And tomorrow it will be over, like finish with the admin part, because then next week I want to start with flows. So is
yeah.
there?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. All right.
All right then. Yeah.
Okay, please send me the recording.
Yeah. All right. Yeah.
All right. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.